Today we discuss how to define functions in MATLAB. Open a new script or new function as shown here. Here you can see the general form of a function with two input and two output arguments. I change the name of the function and save it by pressing Ctrl S. Now MATLAB wants to save this function with its name. Remember that your function and its corresponding M file must have the same name. Before we go any further, in the comment window I type help min function 1. You can see that the command lines at the beginning of the function are displayed as a guide, so use this option brilliantly. Now imagine my function receives two numbers named x and y and calculates their mean value. I change my input arguments to x and y and the output will be x plus y divided by 2. I change the output arguments and save it. Now in the command window I type mean function of 3 and 7 and yes, the mean value is 5. I could store the output in a variable. There are two other ways to define a function. These are simpler ways which can only be used in case of simple functions. Anonymous function. The general syntax is function handle equals to @ open parenthesis arguments close parenthesis expression. The @ is a MATLAB operator that constructs a function handle, which is a means of calling a function indirectly. So in our case, mean function 2 equals to @ x and y, and the expression is x plus y divided by 2. The inline command. Its syntax is function name equals to inline open parenthesis single quote expression single quote comma argument 1 argument 2 argument 3 etc. So mean function 3 equals to inline open parenthesis single quote x plus y divided by 2 single quote comma single quote x single quote comma single quote y single quote close parenthesis. One limitation of using inline command and anonymous functions is that they can only return one value as their output. Primary function and subfunctions. Each M file can contain more than one function. The first function is called the primary function, whose name is the same as the name of the M file. Other than that, we can have as many functions as we need. Subfunctions are only visible to primary function and other subfunctions within that M file, so they cannot be invoked from the command window. Before concluding this episode, let's practice with another example. The problem says, write a user-defined function for the following math function. The input of the function is x and the output is y. Write the function so that x can be a vector. I create a new script and type the formula. It also asked me to vectorize this function, so I add a dot before each operation.